Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
So right now we're gonna get into some curses, okay? On things, this is on reasons on why it is that we go through what we go through today.
Bring it up.
Give me Deuteronomy 28:15.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 15. But it shall come to pass if thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So this is Moses, the prophet Moses, which was a black man. He's telling the children of Israel, which is the blacks and Hispanics today. He's saying what?
But it shall come to pass.
In the future, this is Moses giving a prophecy. It shall come to pass. You with me? Read.
If thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So if we wouldn't hearken means to listen. If you would not listen to the Bibles and the words that's written into, I mean that's written in it. Read this. Read.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
To do what?
All his commandments.
To do what?
All his commandments.
So commandments, like we just read, was a woman not supposed to wear pants. And a man wasn't, and a man is not to wear a dress. These are commandments that God said we ought to do. But if we don't do that, read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses.
That what?
That all these curses.
What is your Madison Pulaski?
All these curses.
Why we don't rule? Why we don't own none of these stores?
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
You hear that? So since we break the commandments of God, all these curses are upon us today as
That's
a people.
Right.
Now we're gonna get into some of the curses, and y'all tell me is the Bible a true book or not? Give me 28:68 to the point.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
Stop. So the Lord. This is Moses telling our ancestors he will bring us into Egypt or slavery again, because Egypt means slavery in Greek. Egypt is a Greek word for slavery. We're going to prove that too. Give
right.
me that in Exodus 20.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
What is Egypt?
Out of the house of bondage.
You hear that? Egypt is bondage, which equates to slavery.
That's right.
Bondage means slavery. When you bound to something, we couldn't get away. We was enslaved. We was taken. Now go back to 68 and 28. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
So the Moses is talking to who, bro? Who is Moses speaking to? The Israelites, right? You agree with that, sister? Okay, so hold that, 28 and 1. What about you, bro? Jew sister? Well, who is Moses speaking to? Israel. Okay, just for the sister, y'all on point, but just for the sister who's listening as well, we're going to further improve that. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Unto who?
Unto all Israel.
To the white man?
Unto all Israel.
That's right.
In the book of Deuteronomy, 1 and 1, Moses is speaking to Israelites. So when you go to 28, he's still speaking to Israelites. When you go to Revelation, he's still speaking to Israelites. And John chapter 3, read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Now he's talking to the Israelites, saying, I'm going to bring you back into Egypt, which is slavery, again, a second time, because we were being taken out of slavery at this time. So he's saying, if you break my commandments, you're going to slavery again. How? How do we get over here to America?
Right.
Ships, right? Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
How?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
You and Moses wrote this over 4,000, 5,000 years ago. It was written.
Jesus.
We just was brought over on slave ships, what?
400
years ago?
400, yeah.
This was a prophecy Moses was talking to the Israelites, proving to you guys we are the children of Israel.
That's right,
but we're
going
to further prove that fact. Read.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
So just why I spoke it to you, is the way it's exactly how it's gonna happen. And you ain't gonna see Jerusalem no more again.
Right.
Talking about your homeland. Read.
And there,
when you get off those slave ships, blacks and Hispanics, read.
Ye shall be sold.
Shall be what?
Ye shall be sold.
Shall be what?
Ye shall be sold.
Read.
Unto your enemies.
No, to your friends.
Unto your enemies.
You hear what God said? Who did that happen to? Prophetic. Historically. That happened to us, right? Y'all agree with that? Where the signs at? Let me see some of the signs. Come look at these signs right here. We was being sold. We got the signs right here showing you us being sold. As most of y'all probably know that it's true. Most of y'all know that this is true, but we just showing y'all through photos of us being sold. Being sold on auction box. Take a look at that sign, sir. Y'all see us, we being sold right there on auction box. All right, showing you that the Bible is true book. This is a true book written by black men. Moses was black and took black people. Hispanic man,
no.
You know what I mean? You understand that? That's good, officer, we appreciate it. Right, our ancestors, so that would be an ancestor of yours, right? Making you an Israelite.
That's right.
You understand? We don't go to the Caucasian men, our enemy, to try and say who we from, what country we come from out of Africa through DNA. We understand it through the Bible prophetically. You understand that? So the Lord said we will be going to slavery on slave ships, and we will be sold into who? Into who?
Our enemies.
Enemies, right? Because will a friend, if I'm your friend, will I take your sons away from you?
Bring
your
up.
Daughters away from you?
Teach
them. Sell them, you never see them again. You understand that? Friends don't do that. God calls them your enemies.
Right.
You understand that? And it's hard, for some reason, it's hard for our people today to understand that this race of people is our enemies.
Right.
We think they are friends because we work with them, because they give us a job. You understand that? Read that.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Come on.
For bond men.
For slave men.
And buy women.
And slave women. Read on.
And no man shall buy you.
That buy you is going into, it's an old English word which means redeem you. Like the officer was bringing out, he was saying how a servant would work for one another. But sometimes we'd be brought out of that servitude by one of our brothers. But the Lord tells us no man's going to buy us out of this servitude. It's only one man that's going to get us out of here. But we must repent first and keep the commandments.
That's right.
You understand that? Then we will be brought out of here. Give me Luke 1. Because you're going to see who's going to redeem us. Who is going to redeem the black man and Hispanic man?
Read it out.
And how? Read what you got.
The book of Luke, chapter 1, verse 68.
Read it out.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
The God of who?
Of Israel.
No, the God of the Arabs.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
The God of the Caucasian race.
The God of Israel.
No, the God of the Chinese people.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Is that what it said? The Bible is saying, blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
That's right.
Wherever you go through the Bible, it's talking about the Israelites.
That's right.
You blacks and Hispanics.
Right.
The Bible is not inclusive with everybody else.
Right.
God is very distinctive on who his people is and who he's coming to redeem.
Right. Read. Right.
For he hath visited and redeemed his people.
No, everybody.
His people.
Christ came for the Israelites.
That's
so
right.
So God is telling you, we will be redeemed from the Lord thy God. Read it again, excuse me.
Blessed be the Lord thy God, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people, and hath raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David.
Who is that horn of salvation, bro?
Teacher.
Huh?
Say it again.
Who is the horn of salvation that God has raised up for us? The horn of salvation. You know, it's okay if you don't know.
The prophets, right?
The prophets. One particular prophet, Christ. That's who God raised up for us. You understand that? Christ, which was a black man from the tribe of Judah. You understand that? Read.
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
Because Christ is in the Old Testament as well. You had Isaiah prophesied about Christ coming. You had David prophesied about Christ coming. You had Moses prophesied about Christ coming.
Right.
Read.
Which have been since the world began, that we should be saved.
That who should be saved?
That we should be saved.
Read.
From our
It's okay, you can say it. The other nations, right? The other nations, the people that enslaved us that we read in Deuteronomy 28, God called them our enemies.
Right.
He was very distinctive and gave detail on who it was. The people that sold us. The people that put us on slave ships. The people that put yokes of iron around our neck. God said those are your enemies. It don't take a rocket science to understand that. You're not for me if you doing these, putting me in these conditions.
Right.
Or you shooting us down. You understand that?
Right.
But for some reason today our people have come confused. Read.
That we shall be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us.
Yeah, who?
And from the hand of all that hate us.
Nah, they love us.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
Nah, let's join hand in hand.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
Let's sing Kumbaya.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
All these nations hate our guts.
Yeah, right.
That's what God is trying to let us know.
Right.
But why do they hate our guts? Because they know who we are.
Right.
They know that we are special people. Give me that. 76. God, this is why they hate our guts, that they know that they destroyed us and made us docile and believe otherwise. But this is the main reason, mainly on why they hate our guts. God is going to explain to you right now. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
Read it out.
Thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So we back in the book of Deuteronomy. Who is Deuteronomy talking to?
Israelites.
The blacks and Hispanics, which is the Israelites.
That's
God
right.
God said, for thou art an holy people.
That's right.
Read.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Come on.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
You hear that? God said, I've chosen you, black man. I've chosen you, Hispanic man, to be what? A special people unto himself.
That's right.
It's 18 nations God created on earth.
Yeah.
And God said, you blacks and Hispanics, out of all 18, I chose you guys.
Right.
You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Read.
To be a special people unto himself.
Come on.
Above all people.
Stop. God said the blacks and Hispanics and Natives is above all the rest of the nation. That's why they hate you. They know that.
That's
they know
right.
You guys are above them. But guess what? Today we become low. We beneath them. Why? Because of sin. Sin reigns prevalently in the communities that we in. Read.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love upon you.
That was it. So the Lord, this is why they hate our guts. Because they understand that. Give me that Ezra 54. We're going to get into some more reasons on why the nations hate our guts and why they put us in this condition. Ultimately, we did it to ourselves because we won't apply simple laws.
That's right.
You understand that? Hold that. Give me another law real quick. Leviticus 21 and 5. We're going to give you some more, get a man some more simple laws that you can follow to clean up your day-to-day walk. You understand that? Let's learn some more laws. Read that when you got it. Okay?
The book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
Stop. So the day is the Israelites. Okay? In the book of Leviticus, Moses is prophesying to the Israelites, telling them, this is the law. They shall not make baldness upon their head like Tyrese, Michael Jordan, Mayweather,
Charles Barkley,
Steve Harvey. He said, don't take a razor deliberately and shave it off your head. Now, some brothers' hair falls out, right? As you get older, give me that, 13 and 40? Leviticus 13 and 40. Because for brothers who hair's falling out naturally, God ain't talking about that. He's talking about take a razor and shave your head bald. Because our men have been taught in today's society, if you got hair falling out your head, you're not cute, you ugly.
So for
brothers, they shave their head bald, say, forget it. I'ma just shave it all off. But let's see what God said. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 13, verse 40.
Bring it up.
But these are simple laws that, brother, you can apply. Sister, it can apply, it's gonna apply to you too as we continue to read. Read this.
And the man whose hair is falling off his head, he is bald. Yet is he clean.
Yet is he what?
Yet is he clean.
Meaning he's not in the midst of sin if his head's falling off on his own. You're clean still in the eyesight of God. Because remember, what matters? What your peers think or what God thinks? Which one matters most, I should say? God, what God thinks, right?
Right.
He's saying you're still clean in my eyesight if your head's falling off your head.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 21, verse 5.
Bring it up.
They shall not make baldness upon their head. They shall not make baldness.
They shall not make baldness. Make it means to shave it, read.
They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
So these are a couple of laws that you can start applying to your everyday life, bro. Because remember, why are we in this condition?
Sin.
Because of sin. Sin
That's
is
right.
what?
That's right.
The breaking of God's laws.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.